churches, we play clubs, we play casinos, we play anywhere that'll let us play, and we don't water down our lyrics, we don't water down our message, and people love it, you know. We don't, you know, we're not in there smoking, we're not in there drinking. Seventh Day Slumber is a band that reaches out to any and everybody who needs Christ. And if you give us an opportunity to play at a bar, and you say that, you know, this is who the band that you want to play here, we let you know right up front, you know, these are our lyrics. We don't change them. And we've never had a problem. You know, matter of fact, the crowd loves it. They come up to us afterwards going, you know, man, I'm in here tonight because I've been going through a divorce, man. And I used to go to church all the time, and man, I heard your lyrics, and I knew you guys were singing about God, and man, I just wanted to talk to you. If you could talk to me for a minute, can we walk over by the bathroom, you know, and talk, you know, and we get that all the time. Yeah.
If you were not in a band, you were in music, what do you think you'd be doing for a living?
If I wasn't in a band? Well, I have a ministry called TeenHopeLine.com. And TeenHopeLine.com, I have 20 staff members and interns that minister to hurting kids from 6 to midnight Central Time every single day, 7 days a week. And they live on our campus. I have a campus in Spring Hill, Tennessee, right outside of Nashville. And I'm the president of that ministry. And like I said, we just minister to hurting kids 7 days a week. Any kid that needs to talk, it's live one-on-one chat, it's, you know. And that's what I'd be doing. I'd be doing ministry, whether it's through TeenHopeLine.com or pastoring or an evangelist. But my life is dedicated to God.
Yourself?
And missions, ministry, anyway. You know, because I've always known that my calling was ministry, whether it be in a band, not so. Once the band stops, we're still going to be doing ministry, trying to reach out to some different ways.
Where do you see the band in 5 years from now?
I think Seventh Day Slumber makes music that's appealing to all walks of life. So I think we'll still be doing, you know, music. And maybe it will be into the praise and worship realm. Maybe we'll venture off into that, and maybe, you know, maybe our praise and worship album will give us another avenue, you know, to reach people, you know. And, you know, maybe we'll do some shows with our Seventh Day Slumber, you know, style. And then maybe we'll do some shows where we just do praise and worship. You know, we'd love that. We're looking forward to every night playing praise and worship and doing a praise and worship tour. Not that we don't like playing what we play now. We love it. We minister to hurting people. But we'd love to spend an hour a night just singing to God, you know, that as our job. You know what I mean? That'd be awesome, you know. So we think we'd probably be something this summer in 5 years. Maybe venture down that way, or maybe we'll be still playing conventions and still playing youth rallies and still, I don't know. We don't know, but I know we'll be doing something with praise and worship or our regular stuff. We'll still be playing.
When you decided to start the band, did you have support from your families?
I did.
My parents, I was 15 years old when I joined the band. And my parents, I told them to get permission from my parents because I'm from another country. I'm from Malaysia. And my parents didn't like rock music back in the day, and so, but they knew it was the ministry, so they let me do that. They thought once I graduated high school, you know, I'd be doing something else, and when I graduated, I told them, you know, I really feel this is where God is calling me to be, and we were making the move from Dallas to Nashville, and so I talked to my parents, and my dad, you know, said, let me pray for a week, and he came back and said, you know, I really feel God is telling me not to push my dreams, and, you know, let you do what God has called you, and my parents are biggest supporters.
Yeah, parents are huge supporters of our
come to our shows, you know, and everything.
Yeah, they pray for us every day. They're huge supporters. My mom is the vice president of TeenHopeLine.com, and we bring ministry teams out on the road with us as we do altar calls. We have our own ministry team and my mother is holding down the fort back in Spring Hill. So I have support, you know, from my family, and Yeah, it's awesome.
Now, are either one of you married?
All four of us in the band are married.
Now, being on tour, does it make it kind of rough on the marriage?
I think it does for some people. For us and our band, we have wives that support us 100% because they know we're not out here trying to get chicks, you know, or trying to look cool, or we're just, man, we just want to help hurting people, man. That's the bottom line. And so my wife is proud of me. She's proud of me. And I know Josh's wife is proud of him. And so is Ray, our drummer, and so is Jeremy, you know, our guitar player. My wife and our guitar player's wife are sisters. But we all live, all four band members live within about a 2 to 3 mile radius of each other. We all live in the same town outside of Nashville. You know, me and Josh live like a mile away, and less than a mile away. And then Ray and Jeremy live on the same street almost. Yeah. And so we all live right there, and our wives can get together, and so they, you know, they get together and they hang out and they have support. So yeah.
Does any of y'all have children?
I have three. Yeah, I'm the only one.
So that's got to be rough leaving the children.
My kids come on the road with me.
Oh, do they?
Yeah, except on a trip like this where we're just coming for a day and then going back. But my wife and kids travel with me a lot. We have a tour bus, and my wife and I and our kids travel. But sometimes she stays home, and my oldest, who's 6 years old, he comes on the road. He's with me all the time. He even flies out with me.
What's the ages of the other two?
I have a 1-year-old, a 3-year-old, and a 6-year-old. Yeah, and my 6-year-old, he's about to be 7, you know, so. Yeah, he flies out with me. He comes in the bus with me. And my 3-year-old, I'm sure, will be doing the same thing, you know, but right now he's still a little attached to mommy. But my 6-year-old, he wants to do everything daddy does. So,
yeah. Nothing wrong with that. When you all are at home, not on tour, what do you all do for fun?
We do a lot of things. I
hang out with my wife.
Yeah, and we go out to the, we ride 4-wheelers, we go out and go to the lake, we ride jet skis, we, our families get together and barbecue all the time, we do movies, yeah, we do a lot of things.
Cool. Yeah. Super Target. Just chill at home, you know, because you just been out for a long time, just want to hang out at home and just enjoy family.